coffin?
Did you remember something?
No, but I have seen this starship before. This is it. This is the ship I traveled in when I escaped from Lenegas.
Three centuries later, and it's no worse for wear. I'll take a look at the internals.
Damn! I'm amazed it still works at all after all this time.
The past meets the present. I really am from a different time and place.
Yeah, but you've got us now, Alfin.
Not only that, but you've helped out so many people, too.
Law's right. Rinwell, too. You're one of us now. No more carrying the weight of history on your shoulders. You're a part of this world.
Right. Thanks, you guys.
It should fly. All internal systems seem to be operating. However, considering how long it's remained inactive, I suspect it will take some time before it's ready for takeoff.
How much time are we talking here?
Starship mechanics are not what I'd call my forte, so I'd rather not hazard a guess.
So we've just gotta sit around here and wait? I'm terrible at waiting.
That's because you're a child. Oh, but how about we use this time to prepare and gather supplies for the trip?
Good idea. Who knows when we'll be back from Lenegas once we leave? We should prepare ourselves for every possible scenario before we go.
Let's try not to stay away too long. I'd hate for anything to happen to the place while we're gone.
Either we race ahead, or we take due precaution to ensure we have no regrets. I shall leave it up to you as to how we proceed, Alfin.
Works for me.
It's funny, isn't it?
What is?
All this. When we first started this thing, did you ever imagine we'd be going to Lenegas? After all, this is the sort of thing I was rebelling against when I ran away from home, right?
I'm sure Zephyr would be proud if he knew what his son was doing right now.
And a little shocked, too.
We're defying the order of things that have persisted for 300 years. Deep down, I knew our journey would lead to confronting Lenegas.
Yeah, you maybe, but you're a Renan. The rest of us can barely even picture what it means to leave Dana.
No offense to Shion and Dohalim, but it's worth remembering we're heading into enemy territory.
No offense taken, and this is no picnic for me either.
Remember, our aim is to ensure that both Lenegas and the Renan homeworld leave Dana alone for good. I don't think we'll be able to avoid a fight.
Is there no way we can talk them into leaving us alone?
The people of Lenegas?
Sure. I mean, we found a way to make it work with Shion and Dohalim, right? And it's not just us. If places like Men and Sia can do it, then why can't
we? Because there are still many of my kind who believe it was right and natural that Renna reigns over Dana. There are those on Lenegas who have never stepped foot on Dana. I doubt whether they'd even listen to Danans.
Look, none of us want to fight. But these are the same people who fired that wedge down on Dana. What happens next is on them.
Right. We're not going to sit back and wait for them to oppress us again.
Right.
Don't forget, there's also a good chance the Red Woman is somewhere on Lenegas. And wherever she is, we should find the Renis Alma, too.
That's right. If we can take it back, then Shion can finally get rid of her thorns. Shion?
Huh? Yeah.
Shion? Shion. Shion! It's your thorns? But why? You okay? Just now, it looked like you used your maiden powers to suppress your thorns. You can really do that?
Stay out of my way.
Wait a second. Are you planning to go alone?
Shut up!
Why would you do this?
I told you to shut up!
I won't let you.
I mean it.
I refuse to let you.
I won't tell you again. Move or I'll shoot.
If that's the case, then go ahead and shoot me!
Do you remember back when I was stabbed? By Rolron?
Yeah. I thought for sure that he had killed you back there.
That wasn't the first time.
Huh?
The first time was when I was only a child. After that, no matter how often, I just couldn't die.
Couldn't die? So you're immortal? How's that even...
I believe you, Shion. But tell me how... How is something like that possible?
My thorns. They're me, but at the same time, not. They're part of me. I have no idea why. But my thorns will never let me die. At least not before I'm meant to.
You can't die before your death?
When my thorns free themselves, it will be my death. I've seen it. A darkness that swallows up everything until nothing remains. It's a vision of oblivion I can't escape. I want to believe it's all just a bad dream. But no matter what I tell myself, I know it's not.
Yeah, but you... Wait. The whole reason you... You needed the Renes Alma was to get rid of your thorns, right?
If I burn away what's inside, then what will happen to the rest of me? Right. Either way you look at it, I'm going to die. But if I am going to die, I figure I can at least take my thorns out with me. That's what I've been after this whole time.
That's why you turned your back on your fellow Renans and chose to fight with us, isn't it? And while we've all been fighting to keep on living, you have been with us fighting desperately to die.
That was the plan. But then I met all of you, and I... Before I knew it, I didn't want to die anymore.
Shion. Don't lose hope yet. We'll find a way to save you. There's still time to...
It's pointless.
Why?
Because the darkness won't just consume me. The truth is, it will consume all of existence as well. It was only a suspicion at first, but ever since the Red Woman triggered my maiden powers, I've been more certain than ever before. It was then that I finally came to realize my powers were holding my thorns in check the entire time. But they don't anymore. Not since Lenegas, when the wedge fell. Every day, I feel the thorn's power growing stronger inside of me. Pretty soon, I won't be able to hold them back anymore. And when that happens...
They will consume all existence.
And that's why you wanted to leave by yourself. You planned to find the Renis Alma on your own and sacrifice yourself to stop the thorns.
But that's... too much. It's way too much.
When this all began, I didn't care what happened to me or anyone else. And what happened to the Renans or the Danans didn't matter to me at all. I know I have to die. But I don't want to. Not now that I have this. I wish we had never met. Then I wouldn't have to feel this way.
Shion!
Alvin?
Living for the sake of dying is no better than being a slave. How can you endure this? Not fair. I don't care what anybody says. I won't let it happen. We can fight this. We'll fight until the end together. Isn't that what you said to me before?
Even if it should mean that it'll be the end of everything else too?
Shion, what do you want? It's your decision, ultimately. But if you decide not to fight fate, I will, even if I have to do it alone.
No, you won't be alone. I'll fight as well.
Count me in as well. I want to be a force for good, not hate.
And me too. I meant it with all of my heart when I told you before. Neither of you are alone in this at all.
You guys...
And I, for one, don't believe this venture is without hope.
Huh?
Shion is the descendant of a maiden from 300 years ago. Given the circumstances, it seems very likely that those events have some connection to her thorns. The true nature of which, I imagine we will discover as we make our way to Lenegas and uncover the truth of what's unfolding here.
I take it you mean we might find a way to get rid of her thorns and she'll live?
It's certainly possible. Though I suspect the nature of the Sovereign is connected somehow.
So be it. I've already lost everything I had once. And I won't let it happen again. Shion. No matter what happens from now on, we're right here with you. All of us are. You are not alone.
You guys, you're all so stubborn. Thank you, everyone. her right now. And a little while longer. I just want to hold on to this dream. And most of all, more than anything else, I want to be with all of you. So let's go. On to Lenegas.
The end of the world. It's hard to believe, isn't it?
I believe Shion is telling the truth. What about you?
As a friend, yes, I want to believe her. Everything that's happened seems to point towards some sort of great danger that's lurking ahead of us. Still, it's hard to fathom something that could usher outright doom to the world. That those really are the stakes we face.
No, I understand. Even Shion doesn't seem to know exactly what will happen to bring it all about.
We have so many pieces of the puzzle in our hands, so many clues. Yet the complete picture eludes us.
So where do her thorns fit in, then?
Well, I imagine they must sit at the very center of it all. You remember the voice we all heard while we were inside the wedge, don't you?
Yeah, I remember. It was the will of Dana's astral energy come to life. Or that's what we all thought.
Right. And from that, we're able to hypothesize how vast concentrations of astral energy can become sentient. Let's return to when we found Shion in Pelegion. When her thorns went wild, they contained far more astral energy than any mere Renin would normally have inside them.
So you think those thorns might be alive too? That their will is what keeps her from dying? But why would they want to destroy the entire world?
As for that, I really cannot say for certain. Its goals still remain a mystery. It may be a mere fluke that her maiden powers have been able to contain it thus far.
You know, I've noticed since we've met that you like figuring out riddles.
Can you blame me? When one realizes that the world they once thought to be true is but a mere facade, they can't help but seek the truth. Especially when that deception has led to others getting hurt.
Dohalim?
I imagine the remaining pieces of the puzzle that we seek rest somewhere within Lenegas. As for what the final picture will look like, who can say? I think it's best we not dwell on it too much for the time being.
Right.
How are you holding up?
Who, me?
Yes, you. You took a hit from those thorns again, didn't you?
Oh, that? That was nothing.
Compared to what Shion's going through, you mean? Still, even if you yourself might be willing to endure that kind of pain, that doesn't mean Shion wants to have to see you get hurt by her thorns, you know?
Yeah, I know. I'll be careful.
Shion doesn't know how lucky she is to have you around, you know? Dashing in to save her at the last minute.
Yeah, very funny.
I'm being serious. You went up and held her close like you still had that mask on, and you didn't even bat an eye. She really needed that. That's what I mean when I said you saved her. Just like you did with the rest of us.
I just want for Shion what we all have. The ability to touch someone without the fear of killing them. Those thorns have robbed her of the kind of everyday things we all take for granted. And it's not right.
You can say that again. It may be normal for us, but that doesn't make it any less special or important for her. I hope she gets what she wants. I have my own dreams. But a world without her, where she dies so we can all survive, isn't a world I want to live in.
Agreed. It's like more and more keeps getting taken from her, and I'm done with it.
Did you know?
You mean about Shion?
Yeah, I didn't have the slightest idea. I mean, every once in a while I thought something seemed a little off, but I never could have imagined. It's like a completely different world was spinning around me and I couldn't even see it.
You and me both. I mean, I knew something was bothering her, but I could never quite figure out what it was.
You? But you're the one always looking out for her, aren't you?
That's what I thought. But in reality, I didn't understand at all. What I thought was helping and being there for her
It was actually just driving her into a corner.
At least you figured it out in time, though, right?
I don't think we're out of the woods yet. But yeah, you're right. We brought her back from the edge, and we're going to stop those thorns from taking her. No matter what.
Yeah, with all of us together, there's nothing we can't handle. Shion, the world, we can save everyone. And I mean it when I say we, Alphen.
I know. No lone wolfing it.
Hey, you're the expert on what my dad would say. Do you think he'd pat me on the back or tell me off?
Zephyr, I don't think that he'd have that much to say, to be honest. You're your own man now, Law. And you've already made up your own mind about what you want.
I guess he couldn't say anything even if he wanted to.
Law.
Sorry. I guess those of us amongst the living have enough problems to deal with, don't we? We'll need all our strength to save Shion. I'll probably end up worrying again at some point. But I guess I'll think it over more then. That okay?
Yeah, I think it is. Can't sleep?
After everything we just heard? How could I?
Fair enough.
Shion's had to deal with so much on her own. Even when we were all laughing and celebrating, she just kept quiet and didn't say anything. I thought she was keeping her distance because of her thorns. That it was because she didn't want to hurt anybody by getting too close. I just figured that that was the type of person she was, you know? But it turned out to be none of that. All this time, she felt like she had to die and sacrifice herself for the greater good. But even then, she didn't think she could say anything to us about it.
I know.
She was so alone this entire time. How could I call her a friend and yet be so completely blind to everything she was going through?
I'm sure it made her happy, knowing you were there for her.
You really think so?
Yeah, I do. If she didn't think of us as friends, I don't think she could have ever opened up to us like that. You were a good friend to her before, and you'll be an even better one now.
Yeah, I really hope so. I want to be the best I can for her. When you think about it, we were all alone in our own way. But over time, we've all found ways to let each other into our lives. I hope Shion's able to do that one day too. No, I mean, I hope she's able to do that more. Lots and lots more. I think it'd be really nice if we could all just be there to support each other when it really counts. And forget about our grudges and pain.
Rinwell. Hey, you doing all right?
I seem to cause nothing but worry. As much as I try to look like I have things under control, everyone still worries about me.
You're not the only one.
Hey, do you remember the first time you said I was your friend?
No. When was that? Sorry, I can't remember.
That's okay. It came so naturally to you, I'm not surprised you forgot. I was different back then. The Danans were not even people to me, and I knew I would always be alone. But in that room with Deadheim, when you called me your friend, it just shattered the wall that I'd built up around me. Because until that moment, I'd only seen you as a means to an end. I thought of you as a way to use the Blazing Sword and to obtain the Rennis Alma. But after that day, one time became two. And before I knew it, you'd made a habit of calling me and Dohalim your friends. It didn't matter that we were Rennens. You cared about us as you would any other people. Then, everyone else started to call me their friend too. To think of me as their friend. Before then, I never even dreamed I could have that. I didn't want to die and lose you all. But I also didn't want to live if it meant you would all die in my place.
Shion.
But then I realized I'd only really been thinking of myself that entire time. After saying how I felt and hearing what you all had to say, I finally understood that. Don't worry, it's okay. I'm not planning on dying anymore. I've met too many people along the way who I truly care about to give in now. So I'll fight. For Danna and for myself. I'll fight against my fate to preserve our future. And I'll win, come hell or high water. I don't know how we're going to do it, but I won't let the world end because of me.
It's going to be a long, hard road ahead, Shion. Our fight won't be over until everyone, both Danans and Renans, can finally live in peace. But I swear I'll be there with you until the very end.
Thank you.
Remember what we learned back in Calaglia? There's no wall so high that we can't break it down.
Yeah, I think you may be right about that.
This ice cream tastes so good!
I swear, you're always having ice cream, even when it's freezing cold out.
And who made you the food police?
No one! I'm just saying that's a lot of ice cream. Don't you ever, you know, throw up or anything?
Did you really just say that? Try thinking before you talk.
Huh? What do you mean? All I'm saying is I'm just a little worried about you, okay?
Well, don't be. I can have ice cream whenever I want.
You say that, but you know what's gonna happen if you keep eating ice cream all the time.
It's none of your business what I eat or how often!
Arguing over the consumption of a frozen dairy product. Ah, to be young.
Naive might be more accurate. All right, it's done. Apologies for the wait, you guys.
That's a lot of fish you've cut up again, Kisara.
That's because I caught so many earlier. If you're going to eat them, it's best to do it while they're still fresh.
Was it difficult slicing up that many fish?
No, I'm used to it. It's no big deal for me at this point.
I know I probably shouldn't be saying this after all the trouble you went through, but I've never really understood the appeal of sashimi.
Oh, I'm sorry, Law. I didn't realize. I only make it because it's an easy way to deal with big catches when I fish.
You haven't done anything wrong, Kisara. Law, if you don't like the flavor, you're always welcome to add some of my spices to it.
Hey, yeah, that might work. I'll just put some of this here.
What's wrong, Law? I've never seen someone jump up and sprint off that fast.
He ran as soon as he took a bite of that sashimi.
Was he crying because of the taste?
I don't think the sashimi is the problem here, guys.
Wow, that's some weird-looking meat you're cooking up there. What is it exactly?
That would be grilled rapig.
What?
Whoa there! What's the big brouhaha?
It's rapig! How could you cook something with such cute little eyes? What'd it ever do to you?
I fail to see what the problem is. Rapigs are perfectly edible creatures. Having said that, I do realize it's become rather rare to eat them lately. What with people increasingly embracing them as pets and companions.
They definitely didn't fall out of fashion to eat because of their flavor, that's for sure.
Agreed. Rapigs have tender, fatty meat. The taste can take some getting used to, but I would argue that's part of its charm.
If the taste is too strong, I imagine you can either just cook it thoroughly or simmer it with some herbs to mask it.
Indeed. At first I wasn't sure whether to smoke it with spices or simmer it in water, but I opted to grill it as is instead.
Seriously, Dol Halim? You have the weirdest tastes.
That's probably because when you live the life of a lord, you grow tired of most ordinary cuisine.
So you end up seeking out more unusual food. I don't know if that's good or bad.
Well, putting aside what it used to be, you've gotta admit it does look pretty damn good. Meat is meat, after all.
That reminds me. I do believe I once read in a book about rare delicacies, how one can go about preparing an owl.
Huh?
I suppose I won't have the chance to try it anytime soon.
Not with Hoodoo, you won't! Ha ha!